Everywhere I went, it was the same story. They didn't even have a corner that wasn't being used.
Well, I'm sure you did the best you could.
I even told them they were about to give birth. They could only give me food.
Well, at least the baby and I are full.
And leaving you in the park all day was awful.
Oh, it wasn't that bad. The sun had a chance to burn out the cold from last night, and I had a chance to nap and rest as we new mommies are supposed to.
I must have went to over 100 churches. They didn't even have a corner that wasn't, or a corner of the building that wasn't being used or filled. And if I hadn't found this box by a dumpster, I wouldn't have to spend the night under that railroad bridge again.
I could have slept there another night. That must have been the busiest train track in the whole world. There must have been a train every half hour.
Half hour? More like every 5 minutes. But tonight, my dear, we'll be staying at the Royal Frigidaire Arms Apartments. Say a cold nose is a sign of a warm heart.
I do have, as long as I have you, but I think the saying is cold hands mean a warm heart.
In your case, both work.
Things will be better tomorrow, you'll see.
I hope so. If I could just find a job, it doesn't have to be carpentry. I'd wash dishes, anything.
You will, and they will find a small apartment that I can fix up and cook for you and Joe Jr.
I'll buy that dream, but it might be a home for me and little Mary. I was crazy to allow you to come with me. I should have left you at home with your mother, at least until I had a place for you. A warm place to stay, your father being a doctor, you would have had great care.
Now you stop that right now. I won't have you blaming yourself. How were we supposed to know Tony was such a flake? We both thought he was honest and had a job for you.
And then I gave him our last money to go and find his own apartment. And he disappeared, leaving us without a penny to our name. And now it is Christmas Eve and we have nothing.
But you're wrong, dear husband. We have each other. We have these nice warm sleeping bags we were given. We have the Royal Frigidaire Arms Apartments. And we have a little Joe or Mary on its way.
I tell you, I must add that sometime in my life is something very special and have God bless me with someone like you.
You did. It was loving me like no one else has ever loved me and being my friend as well.
You're something else, you know. You know, this is kind of interesting. This reminds me of another couple who had a kind of a similar experience.
Really? Who?
Mary. Mary in the Bible, the mother of Jesus.
Oh, you mean that Christmas story people tell every year about the baby in the manger?
Uh-huh.
That's a nice story, but I've never been able to think of it as anything but a story.
I've always believed it. It has gotten me through some very tough times. It has helped me from becoming bitter to events in my life.
Well, that's fine for you. But for me, I just can't accept that story. Guess I'll just have to be the practical one in this family.
Well, we better turn in. Want me to carry you across the threshold? Are you comfortable?
Yes. Although the viewpoint could stand some improvement.
Good night, my love.
Good night, sweetheart. I'm glad you believe that story. Somehow it makes me feel good that you do. But real people, I'll have to remember to ask him if he still believes in the tooth fairy. Real people, I'm sure.
Hannah, it really doesn't make any sense.
I know.
She knows.
But the governor insists that we continue to go along with such matters, and
it doesn't involve us, Lydia. We've been through this.
Excuse me, Mother. I'll go to the well for water. I won't be gone long.
Thank you, Mary. Shalom. We'll help your sister.
Nice to see all of you again.
Shalom. Shalom.
Mary's such a beautiful girl. It's hard to believe she's past 13.
At times, I wonder how long I can keep her. You remember, I was as young as she when Joachim and I were wed. And Joachim proved to be a wonderful husband and father, just the same way my son, Isaac, would, who happens to be on his way to becoming a very successful courier with lots of money.
Oh, Esther.
Now, you have to consider my son, Abner. Abner and Mary, Mary and Abner. He's such a fine young man, studying in Jerusalem to be a priest.
Well, have you all forgotten that I have a son that is not only strong, intelligent, and handsome, Cleophas, but my husband is a town elder. He deals in silks and spices. Mary and Cleophas, Cleophas and Mary.
Aren't you mixed, Lydia?
Fortunately for you, I don't have a son.
And really, this shouldn't be my concern.
It's ours!
No, it's not mine or yours. It's comes. And I assure you, he will not be pressured into a betrothal for Mary. He will wait for just the right one. He has said he must be both rich and wise.
Of course.
But Mary has had a wealth of suitors already. And then there's Joseph, constantly insistent.
But he's just a poor carpenter.
And that he is.
But he is, his father is of the stock of Jesse. And he does have a quick smile and pleasant eyes to behold.
Oh, Hannah!
Yes, you're right. My Mary is meant for a much finer fate than toiling and bearing children for a poor carpenter.
Deborah, what's the news about you and Aaron?
There happens, don't
Yes, Deborah, tell us what is happening. And I saw him leaving your house last evening.
The reason you saw him leaving my house last evening is because he just returned from Magdala and brought me this cashmere shawl. And he's having a chest made for me of the finest camphor wool. I'm so excited. Me and Aaron betrothed.
Deborah, Aaron's having a chest made for you. Who's making?
Now, wouldn't you like to know? Who else but Joseph? Aaron wouldn't trust anybody else. He's having a stone house built for us. It should be ready in the fall.
Deborah, we have to go. We'll talk to you later.
Okay, see you soon. I could talk about Aaron forever.
We know.
Aaron will make a splendid husband, but now back to the chest. You went to see how it's coming, won't you? Maybe we can go check and see.
Mary, you can't go hanging around after him. When it's plain, there will never be anything between you.
Why, have you heard something?
If you mean, have I heard he's asked for someone else? No. But at 21 past, he should be married by now. Why, if he takes after his father, he will never be able to provide much for a wife, and he's never laid anything by for a marriage.
He's been helping his family. The house is swarming with younger ones to feed. How can he save anything? We can start home soon. I'll be home shortly.
Oh, Mary, how are you defending him? It's plain you're mad for Joseph. And Mary, you're the only one he's ever had eyes for. Why, if he's not so happy to you, I wouldn't be surprised if he never married. You're far luckier than I. It's rare if he can be loved so steadfastly by such a man.
Oh, thank you, Deborah. That's such a generous thing to say. But why are you so certain this is not to be?
Well, don't be a stupid donkey. A hen, of course. Do you think she would give you up to someone like Joseph after all her boast about the grand matches you can make? But don't worry. No problem is too great for God. He can handle Aunt Hannah. Oh, look, Joseph's coming. Oh, you're going.
Hello, Mary. What are you doing here?
I'm on my way home from the well.
Mary? Mary?
Joseph, why do you always disappear after the reading of the scriptures in the synagogue without a word to anyone in my family? I miss you, Joseph. I miss you so much. Why do you avoid my house?
I haven't slept, not in weeks.
Truly, that's a pity, but you haven't answered my question.
Please, don't be so cruel, Mary. You know why I'm trying to dwell on other things. The son of Jacob is not welcome in the house of Joachim.
Your lack of sleep must have affected your mind for you to think that way. Come tonight. Come eat the evening meal with my father so I may prove to you how foolish your words are.
Does your mother know of this?
My father will inform her. He'll send one of the children down this afternoon to confirm the invitation or come himself.
You seem so sure of yourself.
My father loves me.
I'll wait word for you.
My father, I must go and find my father and explain to him the love Joseph and I have for love one another. I'm sure he'll be glad. Oh, and my mother. I must find my mother. She'll be glad. Certainly she will be. Oh, my father. I must go and find my father. Oh, thank you, Mother. That was a wonderful dinner. Oh, and thank you, Father, for having Joseph here.
That was a fine meal, Hannah. And fine company, I might add.
You're just a poor carpenter.
You misjudge him, Hannah. He's a fine, upright young man.
No, he's not right for her.
Surely, Anna, is it not your daughter's happiness that concerns you, or is it your own pride?
What?
Thank you. Mary, don't be frightened. Be still now. Be at ease. There is nothing to fear. I am sent from God who has always loved you.
I don't understand.
He's watched you grow from childhood to womanhood, and now he has a message of great importance. So listen carefully, my child, and heed.
I am his unworthy servant. What is it that the Lord would have with me?
Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High.
The Messiah? I am to bear the Messiah?
Even so. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
Me? Surely not me. I am unworthy. I have many faults. How am I to be the mother of this long-awaited child?
God knows the secrets of his handmaiden's heart. He does not expect perfection. This child that he will send you will be human as well as holy. The Lord God wills it so, in order that man who is human can find his way back to God.
But I am not yet married, and it's many months yet before my wedding, and I know not a man.
With God, all things are possible. Now the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, and the child that is born unto you will be the Son of God.
I will strive to be worthy. Behold, I am the willing handmaiden of the Lord. I will be ready and remain faithful. As you step into time, give me the strength to be all you've called me to be.
Thank you.
children, today we'll be reading from Isaiah. Yes. These words have been written nearly 700 years ago. Let us read. The people who walk in darkness will see a great light. Those who live in the dark land, the light will shine on them. There is hope for Israel. Life will not remain the way it is. For unto us a child will be born. And unto us a son will be given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end. And upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom to order it, and to establish it with justice and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will form this.
Father?
Yes, dear?
How can I realize when a baby become a mighty God?
Well, it is simply God becoming human in order to teach us to walk with us and redeem us. So once again, as he walks with us, may we walk with him. I don't know when, but I know what God has promised will come to pass. Now, off to bed with you.
Father, the prophecies are about to be fulfilled, as you have always said. I am to be the mother of the Messiah. I am the chosen one. Humble as I am, faulty, weak, wicked even, God has chosen me.
Mary, Joachim.
You're not faulty, weak, or wicked. Hannah? You've heard the words of the prophets. From Samuel's times on, they predicted the Messiah to be born a virgin. When has Israel ever needed a savior more?
I can't believe it.
Mary, if this is to be true, and not a dream, if God has truly deemed the time to come, then he has chosen wisely. Where else can you find a more pure, more lovely or me?
If it be true, Father, if God has deemed the time has come, Father, it is no dream. I am a child that can only be God's child.
Mary, forgive me. But how do you know?
God's own angel came to tell me. His power overshadowed me. And the child that is to be born unto me will be the Son of God. Father, the Messiah is coming. He's coming with abundant life to bring us hope, peace, love, and eternal life.
Sorry I'm late. I was just finishing a batch of mortar for our home. After all, it's only 3 months till the wedding.
Oh, the house. The wedding. Joseph! Joseph, the Messiah is coming!
What?
I'm not sure how to tell you this, but I'm a child.
With child? Back.
messenger sent from God. I am sent to tell you that you must not fear to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is indeed of the Holy Spirit, as she has said. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Remember the prophecy, "Behold, a virgin will conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel." That promise is to be fulfilled, Joseph, son of David. So delay no longer taking her as your wife.
I will. I will. I believe.
Joseph, Joseph, Mary is here. Joseph, Joseph.
Mary, I thought you would be home for at least a week.
Oh, I couldn't wait, Joseph. I've missed you so much.
I can't tell you how much I've missed you. Mary, I believe.
Taxes are going to be levied throughout the entire Roman world. And to make sure no one fails to pay, they're going to take a new census. They've ordered every adult male citizen to proceed at once to the place of birth to be registered and counted.
Yes, and for me that means I'll have to go to Bethlehem. I'll prepare for the trip as soon as the Sabbath is over. I should leave early in the week. Fortunately, my brothers can register here and look after the shop. As for Mary, my mother will look after her.
We'll look after her.
I want to go with you, Joseph.
You can't, my beloved, you can't.
He's right. It's unthinkable. The mountains are treacherous in the winter time, and the nights are freezing. And what if your time came upon you while you're out in the wilderness somewhere? Tell her she must not do this foolish thing.
It'll be safe, really, it'll be just fine.
Mary, you'd better listen to your mother.
Joachim, speak to her. You're her father. She'll listen to you.
Mary, you do what you must do.
I will take care of her. Well, you must be getting home. We have much to do.
Be careful.
Yes, please be careful.
Don't worry. God will be with us.
Yes, yes, God will be with you.
Oh, Lord, do watch over them and protect them.
Oh, he'll watch over them, Hannah. He alone is sending them to the city of David, to Bethlehem.
from you one will go forth to be ruler in Israel. And when she who